Hi there, this is René for GNS3 Vault, and in this video I'm going to show you how to configure the network time protocol on your Cisco router. Okay, so I got a couple of routers here, and I'm going to show you how you can configure NTP for unicast traffic, how you can configure NTP masters, and I'm also going to show you how you can configure NTP by using broadcast or multicast. So let's get started and let me show you what we have to do. First of all, router Plank and Atomic, they will be NTP masters, and I'm gonna use Stratum 10 for them. So Plank and Atomic, those are the two routers on the left side. So let's go to router Plank here. And what I'll do is say show NTP master Stratum 10 and NTP peer. That's where I have to type in the IP address of router Atomic. And let's take a look. So router Plank, I can reach it by using two different interfaces, but I'm going to use fast Ethernet 0/0, and that's the 12.2 IP address. So peer 12.2. And on router Atomic, I'm going to do the same thing. NTP peer 12.1, that's router Plank, NTP master Stratum 10. So that's good. And of course, we need to configure the clock. So let's set it to the current time, which is 8 p.m. 27. And it's the 27th. December 2011. Let's copy and paste this to router Atomic. There we go. Okay, so now I got two NTP masters. That's the first step. I did this. Router Plank and Atomic synchronized with each other. That's by using the NTP peer command. The next step is I want to make sure that router Julian will check Plank and Atomic for NTP updates, but it has to prefer router Atomic. So router Julian is here at the bottom in the middle, and you can see that there is a subnet over here, 123, and that connects router Julian to Atomic and Plank. So 123.2 is Atomic and .1 is router Plank. So router Julian. What I can do is say NTP server 12.1, that's router Plank, and .2 is Atomic. And we can use the prefer keyword here. There we go, prefer. So I did this task, that's all okay. The next step, configure router Julian so it will broadcast NTP packets on its fast Ethernet 1/0 interface. And the other task that I have to do is make sure that router Century will configure itself by using those NTP broadcast packets. So router Julian's fast Ethernet 1/0 interface, because of that interface, we can reach router Century, and I'm gonna broadcast NTP packets, and router Century will configure itself. So router Julian, go to the interface, NTP question mark broadcast. That's it. And on this router, go to the interface, NTP broadcast client. And that's all that you have to do. So that's working. What else do we have? Configure router Plank to send NTP packets to this multicast address. And router Millennium should configure itself with those multicast packets. Okay, so router Plank. First of all, make sure that you enable multicast routing. So I'm going to do this on router Plank and on router Millennium. Multicast routing. Let's check which interface I need to use. So fast Ethernet 0/0. I'm gonna enable PIM dense mode because it's the fastest way of configuring multicast. And on router plank, I need to use the fast Ethernet 2/0. 2/0 PIM dense mode. So let's wait a little bit and see if anything is happening. Okay, it seems to be working. Neighbor count 1. So PIM seems to be working. And the next step is that I need to send those multicast packets. So what we can do, say NTP multicast, and then the group address 239.555. Enter. Go to router Millennium. NTP multicast client, and then type in the multicast group address. Okay, and that's the last part of this lab. So let's verify if everything is working. So show NTP status. If we do this, you can see that the clock is synchronized stratum 10. And this is a NTP master. Show NTP status, synchronized, it's all good. Now let's check, for example, router Millennium. And what we see here, it says clock is unsynchronized, stratum 16, no reference clock. So that can mean two things. Option 1, it's not working. Option 2, it's not synchronized yet. And you have to keep in mind that NTP can be quite slow every now and then. So what I'm gonna do is say show IP mroute. So let's check the multicast configuration. You can see we are receiving the multicast stream over here from 15.1, that's router plank. This is the multicast group incoming interface, so that seems to be working. So I'll get back to this router in a bit. Let's check the other routers. Show NTP status, it also says unsynchronized. So that's not good. And Century says that it's synchronized. And after a refresh, you can see Julian also says synchronized. Synchronized. Stratum 11, that makes sense because I set it at 10 and this is one hop further away. So now it's 11. And this one says 12. Let's do a show clock here. Show clock. You can see the clock has been synchronized and we can see it on Century. We still see the old time, so that's not good, but I think it'll change. Show NTP status, it says synchronized. The time is still a bit off, but I think that'll fix itself. Let's get back to router Millennium. Because it still says unsynchronized. Let's take a look at router plank here. The multicast part is fine. NTP master 10, that's all good. Multicast the group address 239.555, that seems to be okay. We got PIM dense mode. It seems to be, it's looking good to me, but okay, so another refresh, show NTP status, you can see it's working now. clock is synchronized. So keep in mind, you need to be a little bit more patient than I am when you're dealing with NTP. Let's do a show clock. You can see it's showing the correct time here. So Millennium is working, Julian is working, and Century is still showing the old time, which is kind of funny. But if you do show NTP status, okay, now it says it's unsynchronized. Okay, so Julian is okay, but Century is saying that it's unsynchronized. So let's take a look at the configuration here. Router Julian has NTP broadcast on its fast Ethernet interface. On its 1/0 interface. Which is okay, because that's router Century. And if we go to router Century, show run, we can see that it says NTP broadcast client. Let's do a show NTP status again. Still says unsynchronized. What I'm gonna do is copy and paste the clock set command, because sometimes it helps to speed up NTP a little bit. So let's go to router Century, set the correct time here, 37. And what I'm gonna do is do a shutdown on the interface, and let's do a no shut. And we'll see if it makes any difference. So it's up again, show NTP status. Let's see if NTP debug is helpful. Debug NTP packets. You can see that it's receiving those packets from 34.3 to the broadcast address, stratum 11. So this all seems to be okay. We can do debug NTP adjust. We can do debug NTP sync. I have no idea if this is useful, but we'll just try it. So this is not very helpful. No debug all. Still says unsynchronized. Show NTP associations. So it does show the IP address of the that's router Julian, reference clock, stratum, delay. So it's looking good to me, but for some reason it's not synchronized yet. Okay, so what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna pause this video and I'll wait for a while and see if it makes any difference, because the configuration looks okay to me. Okay, so I just paused this video for about 5 minutes, I think. And you can see that if I do now a show NTP status, it says synchronized and stratum 12. So I didn't change anything, I just had to be patient. But it seems to be working now. And I didn't do a show clock yet, so let's check it out. And it seems to be looking good. So it says show clock, and you can see it has the correct time. So that's it. So that's how you can configure NTP for unicast, multicast, and broadcast. And one more time, if you do this, make sure you're a bit patient, because it can take a while before NTP has been synchronized. Anyway, this is the end of this video. Thanks for watching, and till next time.